Assalamu alaikum students. So last time we had stopped on the disadvantage of IoT. Okay. So before that, hope everybody is good, safe and sound, and you are just working hard with your studies. Okay. So now we'll just have a look of the emerging technologies. In that applications of IT, okay. So we'll just see the applications of IT. Or the IoT, you can say. IoT. Okay, students. The applications of IoT. What are the applications? The very common applications nowadays for IoT is smart lighting. Then second one is your smart thermostat. When we have the word smart students, okay, in terms of your devices or technology, so just understand that it is based on the network, the internet, the Android, so many different things we can use for the smart world. Okay, so here smart, the intelligence of the devices, you can see. Okay, the technology has made the devices the smart devices. Okay, it has given the intelligence to the devices, okay, with the help of the connection, or we can say the connect when it is connected to the internet. Okay, ma'am. And the basic components which is needed here is the sensors. Okay, sensors play a very important role, okay, to make the devices the smart devices. Okay, so smart lock, smart garage door opens, or the opener, we can say. Then we have smart security cameras. And then we have what? Smart traffic signals. We have already seen the examples of all these, okay, in our earlier lectures. Okay, so just go through with the lecture on earlier channel it's available. Otherwise, just go through your lectures on the present channel and just go through your textbook as well, students. Okay, so these are the applications of IoT, that is Internet of Things, smart lighting or lighting, smart thermostat, smart locks and garage door opener, smart security cameras, smart traffic signals. Okay, smart traffic signals is what, students? That you using the augmented technology. Okay, augmented reality, we can have the smart traffic signals, students. Okay, with the zero intervention of the human power, we can say the human intervention is not at all needed when we have the smart devices with us. Okay, so we had already seen these things in our Internet of Things. Okay, we have started in the earlier lecture, we see this. Okay, this we have already gone through with this. So IoT, the smart devices are connected, and the devices are nothing but the thing, storing. And the thing is what? It's an entity or physical object that has a unique identifier, an embedded system, and it has the ability to transfer data over a network. So you have to remember, students, what is Internet of Things? Okay, so billions of physical devices, they are connected over the network to collect, to share data or to transfer data over the network. Okay, so you have to remember this. And the components which we have seen that makes your IoT system, complete IoT system, are the sensors or the devices, you can say. The connectivity, very much needed, then data processing, and then the user interface. Okay, students. So, and we have seen the examples also, few examples in the last lecture. Then the advantages, okay, and then disadvantages. And then we have started today with the applications of IT. Okay, so here the IoT topic has been completed. Now we'll just have a look on the next topic of our chapter, that is the cloud computing. Okay, the cloud computing. Cloud computing. Now, before beginning with the topic, first we have to have a look on what is called as cloud in terms of technology, students. It is not the cloud which gives rains to us, okay? But it's a cloud which gives data, okay? And the processing of data, the collecting and sharing of data to us, okay, without having it stored on our personal server. We can have access to the different types of data with the help of cloud. Okay, cloud computing. So before just having this cloud computing, we'll just have a look on the definition of the cloud. Okay, so clouds are what, students? It is the server, or we can say the clouds are the servers that are accessed over the internet. Okay, the software and the databases that run on those servers. Okay, so in simple terms, we can say the clouds are what? These are the servers. Okay, these are the servers that are accessed. That are accessed over the internet. Okay, students, so you have to remember what is cloud. Then only we can understand that what is cloud computing. Okay, and that is the software. And databases that run on those servers. Okay, this is the general definition of the cloud. Okay, students. So by using cloud computing, users and companies, they don't have to manage physical servers, any physical servers by themselves. Okay, or run software applications on their own machine. That means the task of just maintaining and just storing data, and then just, we can say, what to give access to different devices and all these all gets removed by the cloud computing. That means we don't have to maintain any infrastructure, we don't have to maintain any storage device, we don't have to maintain any server. Okay, why? Because the cloud computing gives the users and companies that they don't have to manage the physical servers themselves or run software applications on their own machines. The user and the companies, they can access all the things, all the utilities which is needed, okay, through the cloud computing. Okay, then cloud computing is the use of hardware and software to deliver a service over a network. What we can say that cloud computing is the use of hardware and software to deliver service over the network. Okay, so this is the main task of the cloud computing. Okay, cloud is what? Cloud is nothing but it is the server. Okay, that is accessed over the internet. Okay, and it is the software and databases that run on those servers. Okay, so we can say that here the task of the person and the user and the companies is reduced by not maintaining any server, by not storing any of the data by themselves. Okay, student. So we have seen the example also the Google's Gmail. Okay, that Gmail users can access files and applications hosted by Google via the internet from any devices. Okay, students, here we had seen the example. Here was in this the example was the Google's Gmail. Okay, students, so Google's Gmail, in this what Gmail users can access files and applications hosted by Google via the internet from any device. Okay, so Gmail, now Google's Gmail, we have so many features in this, students. Okay, okay, yes students, so here it is giving me a break. I don't need break right now because I'm teaching. So let's continue with this. That Google's Gmail is what, students? It gives the user the access to files and applications hosted by Google via the internet, okay, from any devices. So just remember every time, student, that you have to be connected when you want to access any of the feature of the technology, okay. So cloud computing facilitates the access of application and data from any location, okay, worldwide, and from any device with an internet connection. You have to remember this, you know, that cloud computing facilitates the access of application and from any location worldwide and from any device with an internet connection. Okay, so we'll just, yeah, I think we last time we have seen one diagram also, students. I'll just draw it again just to make you understand that few clients are there, client machines we can say. This is going here. These are the client tools. Okay, the clients are connected. Okay. Bridge. Okay. Just type. Client. Okay, and then we have one, you can say the server sitting here in between for everybody, for every client we can say. Okay. This is the server, we can say, which is sitting in between. Okay, then the connection is going on. for the connection of the internet. Okay, and this is your internet. Okay, student. So all the client machines are connected to the to this primary server. Okay, and this primary server is connected to the internet. So the clients can access all the data, whatever they are needing, whatever they need, okay, with the help of this primary server. And this primary server is what it is connected to the internet. Okay, so request and reply procedure goes on, and then the processing goes on. Okay, this is the basic concept of cloud computing, you can say. This is the cloud computing, how it works. Okay, so this is the diagram, students, okay, of cloud computing. This is just diagram for just to make you understand. Okay, so all the clients are sitting at different places throughout the world, and they are connected to one primary server, and that primary server is connected to the internet. Okay, so that is your cloud computing. Okay, then what, students, we have to study about the models of cloud computing. Okay, we have already seen the types and models. So models, we'll just have a look models of cloud computing. Okay, what are the models of cloud computing? So students, we had seen three models of cloud computing. Three basic models of cloud computing. Okay, so number one is your infrastructure as a service. As a service, which we say that IaaS. Then second one is your platform as a service. Okay, service. Okay, that is called as what, students? PaaS. And then the third one is your software as a service. SaaS. Okay, students, so these three services we are going to study. Okay, infrastructure, platform, and software as a service. So infrastructure as a service provides a with automated and scalable environments. Okay, that provide a high degree of control and flexibility for the user. Okay, students, so it uses basically the virtualization technology. Okay, so we'll just have a look on this, okay, in the next lecture, inshallah. Okay, so until then, just stay blessed, stay safe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.